Inshallah, today we'll start a new book. Inshallah, we almost finished. Done the book of Al-Fitan. Alhamdulillah. Masha'Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm asking Allah to benefit us from that. Ameen. The new book is Al-Wasaya Al-Ashr fi Akhir Surah Al-An'am. The last 10 wasiya. Wasiya means, like, you know, the Jewish people, they have the 10 commandments. We have the same thing in the last ayat of Surah Al-An'am. Wasiya means fard. The 10 fard commandments from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the end of Surah Al-An'am. Let's take one by one and we'll see how this is so dangerous. It's a fard from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh, like for example, Surah Al-Nur. This surah, it's fard. All the surah fard. Surah anzalnaha wa faradnaha. We make all the awamir, the advices, or whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asking us, the commandments of Allah is fard in this surah. Surah Al-An'am also, this surah is a Makki surah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send it to Rasulullah, one shot, all the surah, complete surah, Surah Al-An'am. And Rasulullah received it at night, also, it was at night. Angel Jibreel, he was carrying this surah to Rasulullah with 70,000 angels with him. 70,000 angels. Just they came because Allah wants to honor that surah, chapter of this surah, Surah Al-An'am. Mahajja lil-mushrikeen, the atheist people, or the atheist people actually, the one who deny Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the surah is talking about. But in the end of the surah, the main point here in this book, the 10 commandments, Allah and the al-wasiyya from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's see what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. That's actually from verse 151 to 153. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قل تعالوا أتل ما حرم عليكم ربكم ألا تشركوا بالله شيئا ألا تشركوا به شيئا وبالوالدين إحسانا نمبر 2 ولا تقتلوا أولادكم من إملاق نمبر 3 نحن نرزقهم وإياكم ولا تقربوا الفواحش ما ظهر منها وما بطن 4 ولا تقتلوا النفس التي حرم الله إلا بالحق 5 ذلكم وصاكم به لعلكم تعقلون ولا تقربوا مال اليتيم إلا بالتي هي أحسن 6 حتى يبلغ أشده وأوفوا الكيل والميزان بالقسط 7 ولا نكلف نفسا إلا وسعها وإذا قلتم فاعدلوا 8 ولو كان ذا قربى وبعهد الله أوفوا ذلكم وصاكم به نمبر 9 and 10 لعلكم تذكرون وأن هذا صراطي مستقيما فاتبعوه ولا تتبعوا السبل فتفرق بكم عن سبيله ذلكم وصاكم به لعلكم تتقون. Today we're going to talk about just ألا تشركوا به شيئا. First commandment, ألا تشركوا به شيئا. Secondly, it's actually about the shirk. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of this 10 commandments, we have six of them, we call it أكبر الكبائر, the most كبيرة, deadly sin, you know, the أكبر الكبائر. You have to be away from this completely. Number one, shirk. Number two, treating your parents bad, or they call it حقوق الوالدين in Arabic, حقوق الوالدين. Number three, forbidden killing your kids, قتل الأولاد. Number four, اقتراب الفواحش, making zina or adultery or this haram. Number five, killing ourselves or executing ourselves, you know, قتل النفس or killing others. Number last one, number six, النهي عن أكل مال اليتيم, to take the money or the orphan, you know. This is أكبر الكبائر. Let's see first one today, inshallah. First one, الشرك. What is الشرك? الشرك, it's an easy way. طبعا, they have in the language, they said was Arabic language, what means الشرك. They call Ibn Manzur, he said, الشريك, جمع أشراك وشركاء. يقول شريك وأشراك, the meaning, the definition of the word. يقال شركت فلانا, صرت شريكه وشركته في البيع والميزان. If you are my شريك, my partner, in Arabic language, the definition of the word sharik, partner. You're my partner in the business, in whatever. It's called sharik. Sharaktahu, fa'altahu, you know, this is the Arabic language. But the definition of the word, or the meaning of shirk in the shara', in our shara', they said, Ibn Manzur, was shirk, an taj'ala lillahi niddan fi rububiyyatihi wa uluhiyyatihi. To put partner to Allah, in his rububiyyah, he's your Rabb, you put another Rabb with him, to worship him. to call him, to slaughter for him, to pray for him. And he's your ilah, to put another ilah beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is shirk, to have another Rabb and another God, which is ilah, fi al-uluhiyya wa al-rabbubiyya. Tayyib. Shirk, our scholar, they said, we have two types of shirk. It's very important. Number one, shirk yukhrij an al-millah. That shirk takes people away completely from Islam. They are not Muslim anymore. Another type of shirk, still Muslim, but he's still doing shirk. Still doing shirk. Whatever he's doing good, Allah will accept it with sincerity. And what, any type of good deed, he's doing it with, you know, shirk, it's called hidden shirk, shirk al-khafi, Allah will reject it, he will not accept it. For example, I am Muslim, still Muslim, but somehow I will go to that this grave, Sayyid al-Badawi, or Hussein, Sayyid al-Zainab, or al-Jalani, or whatever this Qubur, graves, Mawla, Sheikh, Mullah, they call him, whatever, you know, and I go and I stutter for him, I make my vows, and you know, to him, Nudur to him. This is shirk, you know, this is shirk. Let's see what our scholar said. قال, first type of shirk, يخرج عن الملة, take people out of Islam. Number two, أصغر, it's minor, وهو الذي لا يخرج عن الملة, like what I said. فالأول يحبط جميع الأعمال. That one, which is taking people away from Islam, no, Allah will not accept you in عمل, خلاص. That's why, the mushrik is out. Allah will not accept you from him any kind of good deed, even if you make good deeds. طيب يا شيخ طموحنا, we see some non-Muslim people, they are making good deeds more than Muslims. What do you think about that? Yes. Allah will reward them during their life, but nothing for them in the akhirah. Whatever they do good now, Allah will reward them during their life, because the akhirah is not for them. Why? Because they doesn't have the key. What is the key? La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. They are mushrikeen, they are out of Islam. See? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala adil, he just, you make something good, I will reward you during your dunya, take it. But for akhirah, you don't have nothing. Why? Because he's out of Islam. This is number one. والآخر يحبط العمل الذي خلطه الشرك, like what I just said. طيب, let's see the دليل. It's good to give the دليل from the Quran and the Sunnah about what I'm saying. My proof is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, this Surah An-Nisa, verse 48, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَنْ يُشْرَكَ بِهِ. Any kind of major sin, Allah can forgive it to you. But وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَٰلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. But the shirk, Allah cannot forgive it. But he can forgive any kind of sin after shirk. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَنْ يُشْرَكَ بِهِ. We'll never forgive that. Forgive that. But any kind of sin after shirk, he can forgive it. وَمَنْ يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ فَقَدْ افْتَرَى إِثْمًا عَظِيمًا. The one who sit partner beside Allah is creating firya. Firya in Arabic is different from kadhiba. Al-kadhib, the lie. To somebody lying, we say kadhab, liar. طيب. The kadhib is different from firya in Arabic. Firya, Allah said, iftara. Iftara, that when he created the lie, he did not just get the lie and he said, no, he created. Iftaraha, he created. And not just that, he created and everybody is trying to let everybody believe in him. This is al-muftari. So they say, you're a muftari, you are muftari. Muftari means you're creating the lie. Subhanallah. That's muftara, iftara. Like the brothers of Yusuf. Subhanallah. They came and they said, the wolf ate him. They create the lie. They make the story. They create the story from the beginning. But Sayyidina Yaqub, he realized that and they've been lying, you know. فهنا also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that. Allah cannot forgive a shirk. ومثال الثاني يسير الرياء. The second type of shirk, which is will not take people out of Islam, is still Muslim, but he said here, وقول ما شاء الله وشئت. For example, that hadith, a man came to Rasulullah and صلى الله عليه وسلم, and he said, يا رسول الله, ما شاء الله وشئت. And I said, mashallah means يعني, after the will of Allah and your will too. The main point of this hadith, الواو, the waw in Arabic, waw, the letter waw. Said, ما شاء الله يا رسول الله و شئت, and you too. Huh? The will of Allah and your will. And Rasulullah get mad. He was so mad. He said, أجعلتني لله ندا يا رجل? Did you seek me partner beside Allah to you? Subhanallah. If you want to say something like that, say مَا شَاءَ اللَّهُ ثُمَّ شِئْتْ. ثُمَّ شِئْتْ. Don't say wa. Wa means your. This wa al musahaba in Arabic, they call it. Wa al musahaba. Musahaba means said جَرَيْتُ وَالْقِطَارِ جَرَيْتُ وَالْنِيلِ. They should teach us a little bit of this. جَرَيْتُ I'm running with the Nile. What is the Nile? Nile is water. How can you run with it? I'm running with the train. The جَرَيْتُ وَالْقِطَارِ with القطار. The قطار was running, I was running too. Wow, it's called wow al-musahaba together. مَا شَاءَ اللَّهُ وَشِئْتْ. You are now with Allah. Need? See? That's okay. You're still Muslim, but in the same time, this is type of shirk al-asghar. Ahwat sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in hadith Hudhaifa, he mentioned the same hadith I just told you about it. طيب. This is al-shirk. What is the punishment of the mushrikeen now? We know the shirk is taking people away from Islam. First of all, the punishment for the mushrikeen, the one who said partner beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أَنَّ اللَّهَ حَرَّمَ عَلَيْهِمُ الْجَنَّةَ وَمَأْوَاهُمُ النَّارِ. الْجَنَّةَ is haram for them, forbidden for them. الْجَنَّةَ is forbidden for the mushrikeen. And they're about hellfire. They're in hellfire. They will enter bar. What is the dalil? Dalil from the Quran. Surah Al-Ma'idah, Surah Al-Bayyinah, Surah Al-Tawbah. Surah Al-Ma'idah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّهُ مَنْ يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ فَقَدْ حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ الْجَنَّةَ. For those who are sitting partner, said Allah, فَقَدْ حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ الْجَنَّةِ. الْجَنَّةِ is haram for them. حَرَّمَ. Forbidden for them. فَقَدْ حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ الْجَنَّةِ. الْجَنَّةِ is haram for them. It's forbidden. خلاص. They cannot enter the Jannah. And not just that. Look another one. وَمَأْوَهُ النَّارِ. Will be in hellfire. Imagine that. Somebody, subhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will look the way Allah is going to punish people in the day of judgment. Certain people. Allah will bring them to the door of Jannah. They're going to smell the fragrance of Jannah. They're going to look at it. They will not enter from outside. They're going to look at it. They're going to see the na'im al-Jannah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, I will ask the angel to take them back to the hellfire. What kind of punishment is this? Do you know, subhanAllah, you're so hungry and they give you the food close to your mouth. And they're telling you, see, eat. I say, no, you're not eating it. You're not eating. And this is Jannah. SubhanAllah, what can two punishments? No. You're going to miss this and you're going to go to another one. No. Yes, double punishment. That's why the mu'mineen in Jannah, they're going to inherit the kuffar. And the kuffar will inherit the mu'mineen. We have that inheritance or miraf. And I read all this ayah all the time. What ayah said in Surah Az-Zumar? وَقَالُوا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي صَدَقَنَا وَعْدَهُ وَأَوْرَثَنَا الْأَرْضَ نَتَبَوَّأُ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ حَيْثُ نَشَاءُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inherit us the subhanallah the earth of Jannah. From where you gonna inherit the Jannah? This is my Jannah, and this is the Osama, one of the mushrikeen or the kuffar's Jannah. Who gonna take it? Your neighbor. You are the neighbor of this week, which means you're going to have two jannas. وَلِمَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ جَنَّتَانِ. For the one who's afraid of thinking about that day when we're going to stand before Allah, preparing himself for that, is following the commandments of Allah, two jannas, jannatan. Your jannah and the jannah of the mushrik, you're going to inherit him. And he's going to inherit you too, because Allah created for me, Sayyid, I have two spots, one for in jannah and one in hellfire. Imagine that the mushrik will be in his hellfire. Who's going to inherit my place there if I go to Jannah? Him. He's going to take two places in the hellfire too. He's going to inherit me, I'm going to inherit him. See, the iman is very important. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَنْ يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ فَقَدْ حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ الْجَنَّةِ. The mushrik, Jannah is haram for him. And he will go to hellfire, وَالْعَيْزُ بِاللَّهِ. وَمَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ مِنْ أَنصَارِ. Nobody can help. No helper for the ظالمين وما للظالمين من أنصار. وقال تعالى إن الذين كفروا من أهل الكتاب سورة البينة إن الذين كفروا من أهل الكتاب the kuffar from the people of the book والمشركين and the مشرك في نار جهنم خالدين فيها أولئك هم شر البرية. They are the worst amongst people. شر البرية. And this kuffar they will be in hellfire. ومنها أنهم حرموا دعوة النبي والمؤمنين. سبحانك يا رب. See, because of our iman, we make dua to each others. Rasulullah was making dua for us. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The mu'mineen. Subhanallah. Even the da'wah of the angels. I started my recitation today. الذين يحملون العرش ومن حوله يسبحون بحمد ربهم ويؤمنون به ويستغفرون للذين آمنوا. The angels of Allah, they are seeking forgiveness for you. Not any angels. The carriers of العرش. الذين يحملون العرش. The great angels. They are making dua for the mu'mineen. The mushrikeen, they did not get the dua of Rasulullah and the mu'mineen. Look what Allah said. Surah At-Tawbah, verse 113. ما كان للنبي والذين آمنوا. It is not lawful or for the Nabi, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the believers, like you, inshallah, أن يستغفروا للمشركين, to seek forgiveness for the mushrikeen. ولو كانوا أولي قربة, even if they are part of your relatives. من بعد ما تبين لهم أنهم أصحاب الجحيم. سبحان الله. After Allah showed them they're going to be in the Jahim, hellfire, Rasulullah, you cannot make dua for them anymore. Even if you make dua for them, will not benefit. Even Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Dalil in the Quran. What the Dalil said? Sayyidina Ibrahim and his father, right? In the beginning, Ibrahim alayhi salam, he was asking forgiveness for his dad, Azar. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, no, he's not mu'min, خلاص تبرأ براءه يلا is not your dad anymore خلاص سيدنا ابراهيم وما كان استغفار ابراهيم لابيه الا عن موعده وعدها اياه فلما تبين له انه عدو له تبرأ منه خلاص. That's why the father of سيدنا ابراهيم he gonna come in the day of judgment in the form of a hyena. He gonna be like a hyena, you know, and he gonna ask سيدنا ابراهيم, oh my son, I will follow you today, just ask forgiveness for me. He said, I can't do anything for you today. Yalla, go. And Allah will throw him in the bottom of the hellfire. The father of Sayyidina Ibrahim, like a hyena, subhanAllah. Sayyidina Nuh with his son, right? Ya Rabbi, nabni min ahli, wa inna wa'adaka al-haq, wa anta ahkamu al-hakimin. Qala ya Nuh, innahu laysa min ahli, innahu amalun ghayru salih. Fala tas'alni ma laysa laka bihi ilm, inni a'adhuka an takuna min al-jahiliyin. Said, oh, my son, part of my family. Said, no, he's not part of your family. No, عمل غير صالح. Another citation said, no, عمل غير صالح. It's not good, you know. Don't ask something you don't know about it. It's not your son anymore. SubhanAllah, forget him. Same thing, the wife of Sayyidina Nuh, the wife of Sayyidina Lut. SubhanAllah. This very important thing is telling us the الولاء والبراء. You know, if somebody, is, even if he's part of the family, Abu Lahab, his uncle of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Tabbat yada Abu Lahab ibn Watab. See? Even, I don't want to talk about the father of Rasulullah and his mother, because, to be honest with you, there is no delil. Of course, Rasulullah asked forgiveness for his mom. Rasulullah did not allow him for that. But he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he asked Allah azza wa jal, he said, okay, if I visit her grave, he said, go visit her grave. But ask forgiveness, no. And also some hadith, read that hadith, Salman al-Farisi, when he remembered his father was mushrik. And he said, Ya Rasulullah, my dad mushrik, he's not Muslim. And Rasulullah said, Inna abi wa abaka fi nar, my father and your father in hell. Taban, I cannot assume or say, because there is different opinion for that, the father and the mother of Rasulullah, they are in hellfire or in Jannah, Allah knows. But what can I say? Maybe we can consider them from the people of al-Fatra. People of al-Fatra, that time between two prophets, you know?
Not really.
Yeah, exactly. That time, these people, they did not get a Nabi or anything. Maybe they were not idolaters. They were, there is a group during the time before the coming of Rasulullah. They called them al-Ahnaf. Al-Ahnaf, these people, They did not worship idols. They used to worship Allah just alone like that. That's called Ahnaf, Hanafiyyin. Could be they were part of this people. First wasiyya, commandments, in Surah Al-An'am, what? Don't sit in a burden with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Too many things, type of shirk also, it's very important. If somebody, these people, they still, until now, they do that. If somebody's going to the fortune tellers, Sahara, too many women, they go for this. And if you go to the graves, this is the awliya or the mashayikh, and you make nuzur, and you see this in Egypt, you see this in India, a lot of graves, people, they go there and they make their living from these graves. You see this in, in Jordan, you know, Iraq, Jilani, and Shu'aib in Jordan, Egypt, Sayyidah Zainab, Hussein, Wadol, Subhanallah, and Mulid, Sayyid al-Badawi, and we used to go to this with our families to these places. A lot of awliya, nuzur, and they make mulid, you know, subhanAllah. It's a big fitna. I was in high school. I found, in Egypt, in my area, I found a lot of cars coming, passing by my house. And these cars, they put a flags, you know, people coming from all over Egypt, going to the area there, close to my house. Some graves, they call it the Ta'ima or whatever they call them. And people there, they go and they get dirt and they make it in dirt. The bodies like this, and they said this is sheikhs. Somebody sick, they go there, they're going to be cured from the sickness. And too many things, shirk. And I was asking, what is this? I was going to the masjid. I was not sheikh, but at least I was going to the masjid in my high school. And I used to know about deen. Yeah. I was not sheikh, but I know. And subhanAllah, people told me, these people, they go to the ta'ima or whatever they call them, and they put dirt in their bodies, and they make nuzur, they put money in the boxes, and too much stuff like that. And they start criticizing them. Yeah, I was young. And my mom, Allah give her, inshallah, Allah does sah. My mom is telling me, don't say anything about these people. They're going to come to you, and they're going to hurt you. I said, no, they're going to hurt me. These people, they're dying in the grave, and these crazy people, they go from all over the Egypt, and they put dirt in them, they make barakah, and they make some jahiliya, you know, like jahiliya before. I was young, but against my fitra, my nature, you know, even if I'm not sheikh, but against my mind, it doesn't work in my mind. People coming from all over the states, or they running, and they put dirt, and they put nuzur, and they think these graves gonna cure their illness. And they was started criticizing them, saying it was mad. And my mom said, they're going to come and kill you. They're going to, these people, look how the mu'taqad, you know, she was putting in her mind, these people hurting people. Yes, or benefiting people. This is shirk. This is shirk 100%. Ad-dar huwa Allah wa nafi huwa Allah. You have to put this in your mind. Idha sa'alta fas'alillah. When you ask, ask Allah. Nobody can benefit you without his permission. Nobody can harm you without his permission. This is written, everything is written. It's been written already in Lawh al-Mahfuz. Why then we're going to think about this sheikh? This sheikh is miskin. He needs somebody to make dua for him. You know, he's in his grave. You know, maybe he has a lot of sin and people. And I will finish with this joke. Somebody from Palestine, brother from Palestine, told me this joke. You know, there are two men that came out from jail. And they said, we don't have job to do it, brothers. And what do you have to do? They said, you know, the donkey of so and so died yesterday. What do we have to do? He said, let's make grave, put the donkey in the grave, we'll make maqam, and we'll say this is the sheikh. We're going to collect money. And what happened is, they make the donkey, and they make maqsura, like maqam. You know the maqam? Above it, the grave. And they put the green stuff, and they put box for money, donation. And they wear like sheikhs, they make their, hi Allah, hi Allah, they say, oh, you know, these people came, and the Ammak Sheikh will make dua for Ammak Sheikh. Yeah, Ammak Sheikh will make dua for you. The end of the month, they open the box to get the money. And subhanAllah, they say sometimes like that. And after that, one day, one of them, he was greedy more, and they used to steal the money from another one. And he said, do you know, I'm going to complain you to the sheikh. Who's the sheikh? The donkey. I said, man, we are burying the sheikh together. You know what? We are burying him together. But, subhanAllah. So these people, they are ignorant. They doesn't know. Maybe the donkey, there is not sheikh, actually. SubhanAllah. And they think, they put the donation for taking the money from me. You know, I know some of them, these people, they suffer a lot. They are lying. They are doing a lot of things. But at least we have to advise each other about that and advise people. If somebody going to the fortune teller, this is kufr. Kufr. Rasulullah said that. No. Somebody is going to stuttering and vowing and going to these graves. This is kufr and shirk. This is not easy, you know. And also the hidden shirk, one of them, if somebody, of course, is not doing that amal for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will not accept it. But this type of shirk will not take people away. It's still Muslims. If somebody have riya showing off, still Muslim. But the main one, the one who's sitting partner beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and go to this graves and that stuff. This is so dangerous. Jazakumullah khairan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.